Hi, nice seeing you again. My name is Stefan, head chef at Donald Russell, and in this session I'm going to show you how to cook the perfect pan-to-oven roasting. This method is suitable for the medium-sized cut starting at 250 grams up to 1 kilo, as the combination of pan frying and oven roasting guarantees you the wonderful result for the smaller cuts. As per usual, defrost your meat overnight, remove it from its packaging before you start cooking, pat dry with kitchen paper and allow to come to room temperature at least 30 minutes. It will bloom and look like this. Look at that wonderful red, nice color. Before we cook that wonderful beef mini roast, we have to preheat the pan to the highest setting, the oven to 230 degrees. Now we're going to prepare and season the meat. First, brush the meat with oil all over, avoiding using too much, and season it with salt and pepper. Now we're going to sear off the meat. The reason why we sear off medium-sized cuts in the pan first is to enhance caramelization and flavors, which you wouldn't achieve in using the oven roasting method alone. Place the meat into the pan. You should hear that wonderful lovely sizzle, and sear the meat 6 to 8 minutes in total, turning it occasionally until it's browned all over. Now that we have achieved that wonderful caramelization, we're going to finish off in the oven. So take it and just place it in the oven and cook for the recommended time, which you will find in our ever helpful meat booklet. I like my meat medium, so I'm going to cook the beef rump mini roast for 15 minutes. Now as our roast is cooked, we take it out of the oven and we need to rest it. While the meat is resting, it becomes warm, moist and tender all the way through. Simply cover it with foil and leave for at least 10 minutes in a warm place before you carve it. While the meat was resting, I have prepared some side dishes, some green beans and seared mushrooms. The only thing left to do is to serve it now. Take your rested meat and remove the strings. And carve it against the grain into 1/2 centimeter slices. Oh, look at that. Isn't that lovely? This is what I call medium. Ensure that you preheat your plates. It would be a shame to serve such a wonderful dish onto cold plates. For the finishing touch, we're going to garnish the dish.